Welcome back to another episode of
DC Cafe.
High-end coffee experience and the finale.
That's right.
So here is the final DC Cafe high-end coffee experience. And then next week we'll be bringing you the DC Cafe
Juice Bar.
Juice Bar. I think we've settled on that name. I think that's what we're going with. Mm-hmm. Sounds good to me. All right.
Sounds delicious.
So as you can see, there is no coffee.
No coffee.
But what we're going to do is go through now and rank the four that we have done. Mm-hmm. Rank them out now that it's in the season. This is probably what we'll normally do, but since we started late in the rotation, we only got four in.
Right.
Normally, we probably have like a top 10 of these, but for this one, it'd only be four. So, let's get the finale started.
Woo.
So, as you said, or we said, we're going to rank them from first, second, third, and fourth. Mm-hmm. Not sure which way on the screen it'll be. I don't know, because I haven't edited it yet. But you'll see at the bottom of the screen now, there will be a first, second, third, and fourth place. Mm-hmm. And the coffees we will be ranking are...
Good Folks Coffee. And then we have...
What flavor?
Space. Oh, gosh.
Deep Space.
Sorry.
I knew the name.
I blanked.
Let's see if you remember. So, and Good then, Folks, Deep Space.
And then we had the Valhalla Java.
From
Death Wish.
There you go.
And then we also had the Black Rifle Coffee Company. That was Blackbeard's Delight.
Delight, yes. Blackbeard's Delight.
And then our most recent one was the, Devil's Mountain
Coffee Company.
Black Label.
There you go. So there they are. Now they probably should be on the screen as well, or I'll put them as we say them. I don't know. I haven't edited this yet, like I said, but hey. I didn't think this part through too much. So
do you want to start at the worst?
All right.
Because
yes.
We both agree on the worst.
Let's start. Well, that's where we'll start. Number four, wherever four is. Number four is?
That would happen to be the most recent one. The, the Devil's Mountain Black Label. Not because of the strength of it, because it's too strong. And the flavor doesn't keep you drinking it, because it is so strong.
It's just like drinking adrenaline.
Smooth, but it's strong.
I didn't like it. It made me feel weird sometimes.
Jittery.
It was too much. 1,555 milligrams
of caffeine in that.
Caffeine is way too much.
Yes, that is. So that's number four.
That's number four.
That one was easy.
So
number three,
where would you be?
Oh gosh, that one's hard. Oh my gosh. Gosh, that one was good too. These three are all very good coffees.
Right.
In their own way.
All right, we'll just say our third.
Black Rifle.
Okay, on three. That's cool. Uh-huh. Don't wait for a cue or me to finish talking. All right, so you think it's Black Rifle.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to have to agree with that.
Because I have arguments for the other two.
So, yes, I would say definitely fourth place.
Was the Devil Mountain. And then third place is the Black Rifle.
Black Rifle.
Not because there's anything wrong with it. It's just slightly less than the other two.
It just wasn't as good as the other two.
Yeah, but
there's nothing wrong with it.
Comparing it to a normal coffee, it's amazing. However, compared to the other two, it's not as
It was
good.
A bit strong, too, in flavor.
It was strong.
Remember, because when we made it on the show, we may have made it too strong. We tried it later on, like we drank on it for the probably like a week.
Yeah.
But we tried toning it down and it got better.
Yeah.
But it was just still something about it I thought was like way too strong that I didn't like. Hmm. It was good, it was
the
strong,
smokiness.
But it was just, maybe it was the smokiness.
Remember, it was the smokiness.
It was the smokiness. I didn't like it, I didn't agree with it, and I don't think it's as good as the other two. No, there's no way.
All right.
So, number two.
Number two.
All right. On three, say your number two.
All right. Say it. on the number 30 or right after 30?
We'll count down. 3, 2, 1.
On 1?
Oh, yes. Okay. After I say 1, say the coffee.
Okay.
Say
just
your number 2.
Just making sure I've got the rules correct.
After I count down from 3, 2, 1, mm-hmm. say your number 2.
Solid.
They gave me stumble joke. That's why I keep saying the number 2. I was going to say corny and runny. That was my joke. She stole my joke. Where am I on the screen? Oh, I forgot myself. Hey, there I am.
You're blending in with the wall today.
I do. I kind of blend in with the wall. All right. 3, 2, 1.
Valhalla.
Abraham Lincoln. Oh, Valhalla. Yeah, that was
great. Valhalla.
I want to say something odd.
And that one is just straight up delicious.
It was good. I really liked it.
I was
very
super
impressed.
Good.
It's definitely better
it
than
strong.
The original.
It's very strong.
I put it over the original Death Wish coffee. All
right. So that only leaves the only one other one.
All right. So say your number 1.
Oh my gosh.
3, 2.
It's Good Folks.
Smells like sauerkraut. Oh.
And the only reason Good Folks is winning over Valhalla is because you can literally drink Good Folks all day, every day.
It's the diner coffee one. And that's what the funny part is. So now, if you look at the pricing of it, Good Folks was our first one.
It was
the $12 range. And what was it? The last one we drank was the most expensive one, and we ranked it the lowest.
Isn't that odd?
And then it went, hold on. So then we said Black Rifle, and it was next. So it went like
directly in order.
It
actually.
Went directly, actually in direct order.
That's odd.
So,
isn't it?
Yeah. So it's actually the order we drank them in, first, second,
but
third.
But the Valhalla, the only reason it got second is because I don't think you could sit there and drink on that all day every
no,
day.
No, that's a good morning coffee. It was
a great morning coffee. Good in the morning.
I mean, don't get me wrong. The Devil Mountain was like perfect way to start your day. But my God, I go into work and I was like tweaking going in there,
like running in circles.
Like, I felt like I was on steroids or something. Was
that? But it got to the point where if you weren't burning that energy, you were getting nauseated, like lightheaded.
You get the, like, the caffeine.
Head. Yeah. You get
weird.
The lightheaded, like, woozy.
Like a pre-workout powder.
And I drank a crap ton of caffeine, so it's not due to, like, a caffeine intolerance. It's due to more of, it's strong as heck. So somebody with a normal caffeine tolerance probably cannot handle this.
No.
To be honest, don't try it if you have heart conditions or anything like that, because I honestly think it would hurt you.
Oh, yeah. That's kind of ironic. Their best one we liked was actually the cheaper one. Oh, what does it say about us? We're cheap.
Right. How much was the Valhalla?
$12. Or Valhalla was 14, 16, 19. I think it's how it went.
Yeah.
Yeah, because the last one was actually 19. It was the higher jump up in price. But it was funny because it just went from, like, a really good coffee to suddenly just a high caffeine, like,
whose caffeine's bigger?
Yeah, who's got bigger caffeine?
Who can OD their customers in one cup?
Now, I think it'll be interesting for next season where we'll pick up where this one ended. So that means the first coffee of season 2 of the High-End Coffee Experience will start at the $20 range at the minimum.
Yep.
The minimum price of the first episode of
and
next...
go up from there.
Well, I guess it wouldn't be next year. It would be later this year. High-end coffee experience, but it would
kinda
be the second season.
Kind of look forward to it
because
I've seen the market on this range, and it is very highly
I want to see if the trend continues, or we're going to be like, we're going to keep going back to, like, Good Folks and just say, no, they're the best.
I almost want to go find them again.
Yeah, we picked that up at Whole Foods. Is where we found the Good Folks. But that's a local one, though, isn't
but
it?
But I'm wondering if we can't find it in our Walmart or something.
I've never seen that. That's the first place I've ever seen it at. But it is a local brand, so I'm not sure. Yeah, I think you can order it for sure.
Yeah.
But we picked it up actually off the shelf.
They didn't make, like, tens of
So, if you're ever in the Louisville, Kentucky area, stop at a local Whole Foods and you can get you a bag of the Good Pellets.
There's only one Whole Foods, so it should be hard to find.
Yeah, maybe if you're here for a Derby that's coming up or a Thunder, make sure you stop in a Whole Foods and grab you a bag of Good Fellas.
Good Fellas?
Good Fellas.
Good,
good
folks.
Folks.
This is not a mob boss coffee
shop. And ours was the one we did was Deep Space.
Deep Space, yes.
Highly recommend it.
flavor's
if you're ever
perfect.
In the area, or go online and order it, or it's kind of like a souvenir
for here.
It's
like
a
perfect, like, moderate coffee that just tastes beautifully silky and delicious and just, like, flows down your throat.
So, with all this being said, this was fun. We enjoyed this for the first show of the DC Cafe season show.
And we look forward to bringing you a
juice bar that'll be here next week in this same exact time slot here over here on the DC channel.
That's right.
And we'll be doing, we'll be finding recipes off the internet and trying them out, and then we'll rank or, you know, give them a review on them. We'll do our whole ranking on them, and then at the end of that season, we're doing something special at the end of the juice bar. You'll have to wait to find out. As it gets closer to the end of the season, you'll find out what that final episode is all about. So
I'm kind of excited.
Till then, I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you enjoyed or tried one of these products, and you tell us what you think of them. And I hope you had a
scrumdiddlyumptious
high-end coffee experience, and we'll see you next week for the juice show. But here's to
the first showdown.
Showdown here on the Cafe Channel.
Ting.
And then we'll see you next week for the juice show.
And don't forget to subscribe and check out these videos.
And we'll see you next week for the juice bar.